السلطان سليمان is one of the great Turkish kings who is very famous in the Turkish, Arabic, and Islamic history. The word Sultan means king. If you want to know more about the Sultan Süleyman, I will put all the links in the description. In today's lesson, we are going to use a small video of the Sultan Süleyman TV show, which talks about him and all the things he had accomplished during his life.
أيها الأبطال، سوف ننطلق بعد أن تنتهي تحضيراتكم، وبإذن الله تعالى لن نعود إلى هنا حتى نفتح كل أرض فارس، وكل العالم سوف يتكلم عنا، والتاريخ سيدون اسمنا وأسماء جنودنا الأبطال.
Okay, let's see the meaning of the key phrases. أيها الأبطال، أيها Al-Abtal. We have seen in the previous video the meaning of Al-Batal, which means the champion. Al-Abtal is simply the plural of Al-Batal. So Al-Abtal are the champions. Now let's talk about the word Ayyuha or Ya Ayyuha. They both have the same meaning. This word is always attached to a noun, especially plural nouns. The reason is to emphasize attention to the people you are talking to. Despite the fact that this word is used a lot in Arabic, I couldn't find a precise translated English word for it. However, I will give you a couple of examples to clear the meaning of this word. Let's say I am sitting in a classroom filled with students. They are talking with each other and making a lot of noises. So I stand up to tell them something very important. In order to do that, I must get their attention. I would say, أيها التلاميذ, أيها التلاميذ, or يا أيها التلاميذ. التلاميذ means student. And then I tell them whatever I want. Let's see another example. أيها الأبطال, سوف ننطلق بعد أن تنتهي تحضيراتكم. So I am talking to the champions. So I would say أيها الأبطال. So to get their attention. After that, I tell them whatever I want. سوف ننطلق بعد أن تنتهي تحضيراتكم. We will go after your preparations are done. Alright? Next. بإذن الله تعالى. بإذن الله تعالى. A very popular phrase which we'll be hearing a lot in Arabic. And it means with God or Allah, the supreme permission. In other words, if the God allows. نفتح. نفتح. This word has two meanings. The first one is simply to open or like to open the door. نفتح. The second, which is the case in our video, is we conquest. It's to take another people's land. Ardu Faris. Ardu Faris or Biladu Faris. They are both the same and it is the old name of what is called now Iran. Back in history, Iran was called Ardu Faris or Biladu Faris. For example, بإذن الله تعالى لن نعود إلى هنا حتى نفتح كل أرض فارس. So it means if God allows, we will not come here until we conquest all Iran. So if God allow, we are going to Iran and take it all. Alright. سوف يتكلم. سوف يتكلم. It means he will talk. He will talk. يدون. يدون. It means to write down or to record. For example, كل العالم سوف يتكلم عنا والتاريخ سيدون اسمنا وأسماء جنودنا الأبطال. It means all the world will talk about us and the history will write down our names and the names of our champion soldiers. أيها الأبطال سوف ننطلق بعد أن تنتهي تحضيراتكم وبإذن الله تعالى لن نعود إلى هنا حتى نفتح كل أرض فارس وكل العالم سوف يتكلم عنا والتاريخ سيدون اسمنا وأسماء جنودنا الأبطال.
Champions, we will go after your preparations are done. And if God allows, we will not come here until we conquest all Iran. And all the world will talk about us. And the history will write down our name and the names of our champion soldiers.
Now let's see the video again. You should already understand what they are talking about.
أيها الأبطال، سوف ننطلق بعد أن تنتهي تحضيراتكم، وبإذن الله تعالى لن نعود إلى هنا حتى نفتح كل أرض فارس، وكل العالم سوف يتكلم عنا، والتاريخ سيدون اسمنا وأسماء جنودنا الأبطال.
As always, repeat watching this video until you understand every Arabic word being said in this lesson. Don't hesitate to write down your comments and suggestions in the comment section below. Like and subscribe to my channel to get an instant notification the second I upload a new lesson. Hope you enjoyed today's video, and I will see you guys in the next one.